I grew up with it as a boy, train spotted, travelled on trains on the line, and generally had a love of steam.
We lived by the trains. My father went to work when one went past, my mother put the dinner out when another one went past, so I've grown up with it.
My mother used to take me to see my grandfather driving steam trains on the East Coast Main Line when I was young, as in a pushchair.
For decades, the Great Northern Railway played a vital role in transporting both goods and passengers all over Lincolnshire. But in the 1950s, much of the line had fallen into disrepair, and many of the stations in the county closed for business forever. That made stations such as this one, which remained open, hugely important for people living here in the area, as they were trying to make up for Lincolnshire's lost railways.
Mablethorpe. It was like a different place over 50 years ago, and that was the case for many Lincolnshire villages. The railway was like a hub, a catalyst for business, a way to drag in tourists from all four corners of the country. But it's a part of our history that is in danger of being lost forever. Well, that was the case until a group of volunteers took it upon themselves to restore a historic part of the line between Ludborough and North Foresby.
Originally, a gentleman called Barry Herbert, who used to write books about railway ghosts, sent a letter to the Grimsby Telegraph when this was still open as a freight line. And he got together a group of people. This was 1978, and it was over 2 years before the line finally closed, and they fought to keep it open.
We had a lot of opposition in the early days. British Rail were very uncooperative, shall I say, but in the end we actually won them over. We managed to buy the land, which at that time was all the way from Garden Street Junction in Grimsby to Keddington Road at Louth.
There were quite a few critics who said, no, you won't do it, you're all just dreaming, you know, you're all little lads playing at trains. But we've had one or two come back and apologise and say what a good job we've done, and they're amazed that we've done it.
But it's not just here in Lincolnshire that this section of track has huge historical significance.
I think personally it's very important, not only just for Lincolnshire, but the fact that it was where the first ever Great Northern Railway train ran. Not King's Cross, Doncaster, York, but from Louth to Grimsby on the 1st of March 1848.
And for some of the volunteers, such as Olive, it's far more than just helping to restore this line. They've gone one further and bought their own steam engine.
My husband and myself, we've got no children, grandchildren, no close relatives, so we thought we may as well enjoy our own money doing something we want and helping the railway as well. I mean, they do pay us every time they use our engine. It's not down here simply, as a plaything.
And it's still looking good for the railway, as they now plan to extend the line several miles down the road to Louth. That is, once they've raised the £2.5 million needed to do the work.
We're gradually relaying the track. We're now starting to lay some track towards Louth, having done a lot of modifications and new installations of track at Ludborough. And we're developing that way.
However, everyone at the railway knows that this isn't going to be an easy task.
We need every bit of help we can get. We need people to do things from cleaning toilets, painting, training to be footplate crew, operating the signal boxes, you name it, we can use you somehow.
A very, very friendly place with lots and lots of very nice people who are all united in a passion for railways and a passion for helping people, if you like, in that it gives us all great pleasure to actually achieve something. It's job satisfaction.
But the Lincolnshire Waltz Railway isn't the only place working to try and restore Lincolnshire's railway heritage. It's now late November and the weather has begun to turn for the worst. But at Bardney Heritage Centre, it's still business as usual. On the site of the old Bardney railway station, Barry Newlove and his partner have transformed what was a derelict site into a place that can be enjoyed by all.
We just drove over the bridge. There's a bridge just by us which the railway put in many years ago, and we just came across in the goods shed, which where we live in. It's the roof fell down one day and collapsed, and then we said, well, it's about time somebody did something with it. So we inquired, and then with it being a Grade 2 listed building, it was quite difficult. And we just took it from there. We did the shed, and then we thought, right, then we'll do a station. So we did a station, and then we thought we'll put a platform up and a canopy up. And it slowly takes over.
But the question is why? Why would you risk everything you have on such a difficult and complex project?
It's magical. The new railways, the diesels types, they're wonderful in their own sense, but it just hasn't got the imagination and the feel of the steam. I would have loved if they wouldn't have gone in the first place. I mean, I think the mistake is that they let all the stations go on the track bed. They should have at least kept the track bed. And then, if you look at the future, what future have we got on the roads? The full. Then the railways, it's the perfect answer.
However, unlike Ludborough, there isn't a steam train in sight. Instead, a railway-themed cafe, the village chippy, and what has to be one of the most unique bed and breakfasts in the whole of the country.
Well, it's an old railway wagon, and basically, not a carriage, a wagon. So it will have had livestock in. So it's a bit unusual. So what we're trying to do is just recreate the feel of the railways.
And by doing this, the Heritage Centre now attracts thousands of visitors each year, some to view the unique attractions, and others to just sit back, relax, and enjoy a cuppa or a Sunday roast in the cafe. But how do you convince your partner to allow you to go ahead with such an expensive dream?
Well, she's as bad as what I am, and we're both as bad. We have been known to travel a few hundred miles just to see an engine flash past, and that's what it's all about, is the smell, the noise, the speed, and you get this huge engine flash past, which, pulling all these carriages, it's magical.
And with Barry's enthusiasm and determination to do his bit to keep another part of Lincolnshire's history alive, who knows what Bardney will look like in 20 years' time. But the thing I've learnt is, no matter where you go, everybody shares that same passion for Lincolnshire's old railways.
We couldn't do it if we went to work, I'll put it that way. But we've both been here, this is our 20th season.
You see these huge monsters, and when you're small and look up, and the steam and the smell, the noise, it's incredible.
I started off with the old train spotting thing, and it's just gone on from there. And it became hands-on after BR Steam had finished, and I lost a bit of interest. And then when Preserve Line started up, I started to get interested again.
Without the volunteers, we wouldn't be here. But everything you see, we've done from scratch.
It really is amazing to think that once this was just a normal part of Lincolnshire life, but now it's something that we can all celebrate and appreciate. But I've only just touched the surface, and work will continue to go on way into the future, restoring Lincolnshire's lost railways.